Mackenzie Elise here of Bowman Library with a whole new teen book spotlight. So for this week, we are exploring stories, and I will say we have some fiction, we have some nonfiction, we have some graphic novels, but we're exploring stories or tales or the theme that explores what it means to be a family. Given that we're kind of in this like this season between like Thanksgiving and all the December holidays, that it gives us some time to reflect upon what family means to each of us. And books allow us to do that as well, because family doesn't have to be your blood relatives. Your family can be whomever it is that you choose to be family with. And keep that in mind as we look at these books, that families play a different role throughout each of them. So let's take a look at these six amazing titles, starting with our first one, The How and the Why. So the whole time she has been growing up, Cassandra has known that she's been adopted by her incredibly loving parents. They haven't kept this a secret from her. When she turns 18 though, she decides that she wants to start trying to figure out who her birth mother actually is. And she wants to know the how and the why as to why she was adopted. Like, what led to this point in all of their lives? Now, running into multiple dead ends, she starts to wonder if she would ever learn the truth. Now, as you read this story, interspersed throughout are letters that were written by Cassandra's birth mother to her unborn child. And as you read these letters, you start to get a clear picture of the events leading up to the decision for Cassandra to be put up for adoption. But as you go, you will also be on this journey with Cassandra as she figures out, like, what does family mean to her? Like, why does she feel this need to do this? But if she ever does figure out the truth, is it going to change anything? Cassandra's friends and families are truly supportive. They are realistic and throughout this whole process, and you as the reader will be so glad that you went on this journey with Cassandra as she tries to complete her sense of self and, again, the how and the why. An amazing read. Almost American Girl. So this graphic novel memoir is all about Chuna, who, when she's 14 years old at the start of the book, she's living in South Korea and was a typical teenager. She had this awesome relationship with her single mom. Dad, wasn't really in the picture. And things are going great. It's when her mom announces they're going on vacation that Chuna's excited, because they've been on amazing vacations before. They've been to places like Singapore and Hawaii, and she cannot wait to find out where they are going next on another incredible journey together. But when her mom announces that they're going to Alabama, there's this moment of like, what? What are we doing? When they arrive there, Chuna's also shocked to find out that this is not a vacation like her mom said it was. They are actually moving there. So they're leaving South Korea, moving to a whole new country, moving to Alabama. And that's where her mother is marrying a man named Mr. Kim, who also has his own children. Not only faced with all of this news, she now finds herself trying to navigate this new place, this new culture, this new language, new foods, new school, all while facing her classmates and her extended family. There's incredible amounts of bullying that goes on, but you will see through her experience, like you will see through her eyes, and you will be along for the journey of Chuna, whose English name is Robin, as she moves from Seoul to Alabama, eventually Virginia. Anyone who feels as though they've never fit in can truly relate to this. And again, I will ask you, like, again, it explores this concept of what is family? Almost American Girl. Patron Saints of Nothing. Love this one. Okay, 17-year-old Jay, he's trying to make it through his senior year, especially since he's already been accepted to Michigan State, so he has severe senioritis. Now Jay, who was born in the Philippines, he's grown up in the United States. He finds out that his favorite cousin Jun, who is also the same age, has been killed back in the Philippines though, presumably because he was selling and using drugs. And what I'm gonna tell you is the truth over in the Philippines. In the Philippines, using and selling drugs, that's a crime punishable by death. Like, yeah, like that's just what the consequence is, as crazy as that may sound. How that's like such an extreme. Now, Jay does not believe that's the case. There is no way that his cousin was selling using drugs. And he convinces his parents that not only that he wants to go on an early senior grift, like he wants to take his early senior gift and go on a trip to the Philippines. And he's going to spend 10 days there with the goal of trying to figure out what really happened to his cousin. Now, while he's there, he rediscovers the culture that he's long forgotten, as well as family members that he's never met, all while trying to figure out and discover the many secrets his cousin was holding onto that Jay had no idea. Now, this is part mystery, part realistic, part a look at history and the current state of the Philippines. You will not be able to put this one down again. I loved this one. Highly encourages Patron Saints of Nothing. The Family Romanoff. Another amazing title here. I'm just going to say that right now. And it's also by an amazing author, Candace Fleming. Yeah. If you watch enough of these, you know, Candace Fleming and I, she's amazing. Everything she writes, amazing. No exception. So, I will tell you this, when I started to read this, my baseline of my knowledge of the Romanov family from like Russia was the movie Anastasia, and like what you like hear about and read about, like the lost princess of Anastasia. So, didn't really know a whole lot going into this one, gotta be completely honest, based on what I just told you. But Fleming takes us into the family of the Romanovs and shares everything about their rise and fall from power. Now again, keep in mind, this is the family that includes Anastasia. Like, this is the whole royal family right there, the Tsar, Tsarina, their kids. So, you know, people have thought that the princess escaped and that she's still alive. Some people have even come forward claiming to be her. But Fleming will weave through history to show how that isn't the case. You will also, as the reader, as you realize this, you start to kind of understand, maybe, you know, sympathize with the Russian people, why they felt the way they did and why they decided to lead a revolution against the established government. But there was so much more that happened past that moment, past when they were taken prisoner. And yeah, I mean, like, it's an amazing, crazy piece of history that you need to read. Now, again, Candace Fleming does an amazing job. There's pictures in it. It reads as a story. You will think you were actually in, like, you know, 1910s Russia. Yeah, amazing read. But it's to take a look at, you know, what this family looks like through the lens of history, the Family Romanov. Hope and Other Punchlines. So 17-year-old Abby is best known as Baby Hope. Now, I will start by saying what I'm about to say is fictional. It is a fiction book, okay? Now, her character, Baby Hope, is synonymous with September 11th, as she's the one-year-old baby being rescued from a daycare center, bringing people around the world hope in a time of crisis. And this picture has, like, again, like when people, like, in this book think of 9/11, they think of this fictionalized picture of Abby at 1 year old. But now, she just wants to be Abby. When she gets a job at a summer camp that's out of town, she hopes that no one will know who she is, but that does not turn out to be the case when fellow camp counselor Noah recognizes her, like, immediately. And soon, she unknowingly gets sucked into this mission he is on, which is to solve one of the most haunting questions of his life. What happened to his father on September 11th when he went to work at the World Trade Center but did not come home? And he thinks Abby and her picture hold the key to solving this mystery that has been weighing on him for the past, like, 17 years of his life. Now, this look at the events of that day told through the eyes of two individuals, how it impacted, it's a unique take. There is a touch of romance, there's some mystery, there's some history built into it, hope and other punchlines. And our last one is Sia Martinez and the Moonlit Beginning of Everything. So Sia has been in mourning for the loss of her mother, who disappeared while trying to return home back to the United States after being deported to Mexico. Now, living with her park ranger father, once a month, Sia goes out into the desert that claimed her mother, and she has these hopes that she's going to find her mother in this desert, and she's going to bring her home. Yeah. That's what Sia is doing to cope with what she's going through. Now, it's during one of these visits at night that she meets Noah, and they soon become friends with this growing attraction. But Sia and her friend Rose cannot help but feel that Noah has a secret. Now, one night when they are in the desert, they see this unidentified flying object crash into the ground, and it is her mother that emerges from the wreckage. Oh yeah. Now, if you're looking for a science fiction read that is filled with government intrigue, family drama, and some romance, you'll be turning the pages as fast as you can because you want to figure out what actually is going on here. Like, is her mother really dead, or is her mother like alive in a UFO? See You Martinez in the Moonlit Beginning of Everything. So these are just six different books that we have here at the library that explore this theme of a family, what it means to us, how it could be different for everyone, and that's totally okay and fine. Everyone has their own unique families. Some are born, like we're born into them. Others, though, are people that we choose to make part of our family, and these books just help us explore those thoughts and feelings. So I encourage you to come out. Check out one of these, or we can help you find some other perfect book, you know, that you want to maybe read, maybe get your reading checklist on your Goodreads challenge if you're like me. So come on down, we can help you find those books you're looking for. I hope you tune back next week when you have a whole new Teen Book Spotlight, and have an amazing week.